Valeria Yamamoto. Her style is more surreal.
It has something to do with when you see the birds passing by. It's breathtaking and it's beautiful.
My name is Ari Kaplan Nakamura. I'm an artist. I live in Buenos Aires, Argentina.
Ari Kaplan Nakamura is working in a style that I think can be explained as futurist, depicting movement within one frame.
After my trip to Japan, my perception of time changed. And that have an impact on my art, obviously. It's the way to think about moments.
Ms. Heimberg is a realist. She's exploring urban landscapes and the relationship of the Argentinian-Japanese community within that landscape. Guillermo Bueno is working in a formalist method that explores traditional poses and landscapes and textures. He does so in a way that captures, I think, the quietude of the Japanese meditative experience.
My name is Lucila Heimberg. I am a photographer, and I was born and live in Buenos Aires, Argentina.
Valeria is from Spanish origin, and Yamamoto is from my father, that is, he came from Japan.
My Japanese background influenced my art.
In the 21st century, it is the century of Asia.
The installation is called Fly Away. The idea was of the flight, and then the way to arrange it, the more natural way, it was to find a picture of the flock of birds, and then I try to replace. So you have a natural pattern on it. That's why it feels so fluid.
Brickell Gallery Night in general has been a very rich resource for art goers, art collectors in the Miami area, because you've presented over the years a number of different kinds of art. Every exhibition has been fascinating and varied. So now, with this new concept of West Encounters East, we have a whole new opportunity to present this concept of this beautiful fusion of cultures and the richness of that expression that we bring to the Miami market now.
There's approximately 35,000 Argentinian citizens with Japanese roots, and over the ensuing decades throughout the 20th century, the population has increased. They have established firm economic roots and maintain their culture. What's exciting is that Stella Holmes is just intuitively and instinctively understands the relationship of how Western art has always looked to Eastern traditions in the modern era.
I think it exposes people to a large number of cultures, which you really want to do, because you do want people to understand. You want people to have understanding of other people, other ideas, other perhaps belief systems, if you want to look at it that way, but other art forms as well.
like is how the people react to the sculpture or the thing, and I like to listen what they get out about it.
I mean, I think the art's beautiful, and it's very clear that some of these artists, although many of them are in the position where they sort of, some of them somewhat reject their traditional roots, and they're adopting a more global look at their art, and you know, adopting Western ideas in what they do. There's still that hint of their homeland, of their own culture, and that's impossible to remove. You really can't remove. And you don't want to remove it. You really want them to be different.
When I walked in, I was blown away. That's a better way to talk about it. It's one of the most poetic and beautiful works I've ever seen, but it is a sensational work of art that has the oriental spareness and at the same time a great sense of poetry that should reach anyone anywhere, whether you're Japanese or Argentine or Floridian or whatever you are. I think it will be something that everybody here relates to.